Hey, what's going on everyone? Welcome back to another episode of Star Wars Coffee, where in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at a Cara Dune spinoff show with Bo-Katan. That's today here on Star Wars Coffee. Greetings, Exalted Ones. Greetings to all you Jedi, Padawans, and younglings out there. This is Star Wars Coffee, covering everything you need to know about the latest developments, news, and leaks in Star Wars, and as always, giving you my analysis. Cara Dune, a veteran of the Galactic Civil War who fought under the banner of the Rebellion. Cara Dune is a seasoned warrior, intimidating brawler, and crack shot. Cara has put her days of military discipline behind her and has now reinvented herself as a mercenary. The Mandalorian Season 2 is fast approaching, and with that being the case, LRM has a new update about a Cara Dune spinoff show. Now, I've reported about this, I believe last year, around the time of the Disney earnings call when they were talking about the future of Disney Plus, and Cara Dune was one of those names mentioned, and it is back again. It is exciting to think that we are just a couple of weeks away from the Season 2 premiere of The Mandalorian. It's hard to imagine that just a year ago this show would be leading to a wider universe of shows on Disney Plus for Star Wars. Should we have expected anything different? No. Because this is the way. Leading up to the upcoming season, there has been rumors of spin-off shows including Ahsoka Tano, Boba Fett, and Ezra Bridger, all of which we have covered on this channel. So now it seems that we have another name continued to be pushed forward with that list, and that is Cara Dune, played by Gina Carano. So this news came right off the heels of the CEO of Disney, Bob Chapek, who had replaced Bob Iger, making the announcement of the restructuring of the Disney Entertainment, namely a big push for Disney Plus Originals. With the recent success of the streaming service subscriptions, Chapek wants a constant flow of Disney Plus content in the future. Brilliant idea. It essentially boils down to like the main networks of NBC, CBS, ABC, all of those with their original shows. Now Disney Plus is essentially going to be a subscription-based service with that, which is a brilliant idea from not only a business standpoint, from a content creation standpoint, given the entities that they possess. So, this has led to a push from all of Disney's properties to focus their attention to content focused on Disney Plus. It seems like the idea of a Cara Dune show could be the result of these recent changes and its continued pushing forward. While there isn't any details about the show that what it would be about, it is likely that it would be a prequel series to when we are introduced to Cara and the Mandalorian. This would be very similar to what Lucasfilm is already doing with the Cassian Andor series. Cara's backstory is that she was a human, female Alderaan. From Alderaan, Cara served as a shock trooper in the Alliance during the Galactic Civil War, and this would allow Gina Carano to develop Cara's origin story and how she became the character that we know her as when we meet her in The Mandalorian. And an update from this story is Corey Van Dyke over at Kessel Run Transmission has corroborated the original report from LRM about the Cara Dune scoop with the following tweet. We can definitely back this up, as it's something we've heard from some of our sources from a while back. Cara will probably have a little help from some friends in the series though, and what he is hinting at there is Bo-Katan. So, Bo-Katan, for those of you who don't know, is a gifted warrior, a legendary Mandalorian who refused to align with the Empire's occupation of Mandalore and now wields the Darksaber as the leader of the Mandalorian Resistance. And so, this now reports by Bo-Katan herself, who we know is being played by Katie Sackhoff, who voiced her in The Clone Wars, and is now going to reprise her in The Mandalorian Season 2. So, from that, there was a tweet put out by Star Wars Underworld reporting that a Mandalorian spinoff series starring Cara Dune and Bo-Katan is in development. Now, that in itself is not big news, but what is big news is Katie Sackhoff herself, the actor who plays a Bo-Katan, had liked that tweet. And she was not tagged in it. She did not do anything of the sort. She was not tagged in it. She was not mentioned in it by name. She just liked the tweet, which give us the indication that this is the real deal. So Noah Outlaw posted a retweet and a photo of this saying, Katie Sackhoff liking a tweet about our report. Coincidence? I think not. And in this case, I tend to agree with him. It is no coincidence in my mind that Katie Sackhoff, the one we know who is playing Bo-Katan in Season 2 of The Mandalorian, has liked a tweet validating this report about the Cara Dune spinoff series. This likely suggests that both of these women have been in talks to reprise these characters for their own Disney Plus series. And that would be excellent news, as this both of these characters are extremely intriguing to me, and I can only imagine how excited that they would be continuing this Clone Wars lore and developing its own Mando spin-off as well. So it's kind of like the best of both worlds. Let me know what you guys think about this in the comment section down below. Thank you guys for watching. May God bless you and the Force be with you always. If you enjoyed this episode, and frankly, even if you didn't, don't forget to subscribe.
Do it!
And if you want to help spread the word, please give this video a thumbs up and tell your friends to subscribe. Please check out the official Star Wars Coffee merchandise, and don't forget to check out all of the content playlists on this channel, including The Rise of Skywalker, The Mandalorian, and much more.